Hello everyone and welcome back to Animation Pilgrimage, where Sean and I take a look at every single theatrically released animated film in chronological order. I'm Tennille.
And I'm Sean.
Today we looked at the 1971 film, Daisy Town, or if you're in America, it was known as Lucky Luke.
Oh, so it was changed to Lucky Luke for America.
Yeah.
The main character is Lucky Luke. It's based on a comic under the name Lucky Luke.
Yes.
So,
I think in America, it's just called Lucky Luke because that's a more marketable name than Daisy Town.
I guess that's fair.
Anyway, this is another Western. We don't get those all that often. And like we said before, it was based on a comic book. And that comic book was written by the Belgian France illustrator Maurice, as he is known, or Maurice de Bevier, or Maurice de Bevier, but he's better known as just Maurice.
Okay.
In his home country. And it was a comic written in 1955, I want to say. Give me just one second.
So is this not the Asterisk the Gaul people?
Well, one second.
Okay.
The comic was created by Morris in 1946, and Morris did all the writing and the drawing for the series single-handedly until 1955, and that's when he started collaborating with René Goscinny, who is the Asterix creator.
Okay.
So that's when they started working on it together, and then they continued to work on it until Morris's death in 2001.
Okay. That's a very long-running comic. Holy crap.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if he was the one... it seems to imply that he was the one who was doing the comics, you know, that entire time, but who knows? Maybe it's like a Jim Davis situation where he had other writers come in and help, and, you know, he... like, his name is still on it, but he's not necessarily doing the comics anymore. I'm not sure. I would have to look more into it. But from the brief research I did, that was the impressions I got.
Okay. All right. Before you get into this,
mm-hmm.
How about you let me get into this?
Okay.
Get into the plot summary. And we're going to do a relatively quick plot summary. No interruptions.
Okay. Go ahead.
And then we'll go from there.
Go ahead.
So, the movie starts with an amusing sequence of a bunch of pilgrims out in the middle of the desert, and they find a daisy, and they're like, alright, this is where we're gonna be, and we're gonna call it Daisy Town. So then the credits are over this scene of them just building the town as they go in, like, a really strange, cartoonish fashion, which was actually kind of amusing.
Mm-hmm.
It is immediately run over by all the villains of the West, so...
Desperados
and, like, bank robbers and all those kind of things. Enter Lucky Luke, our main character, small of word, and he is better than all these other people because he can beat them all up. Also, he smokes.
He's better, he's quicker with a gun than his shadow is, like, his tagline.
Okay. Well, he's better at beating other people up than they are beating him up, so therefore he is the good guy. And he smokes. Always. Anyways, another thing that makes him better than anyone else, I guess, is that he doesn't actually kill anybody. No, instead he just tars and feathers them, because he is now the sheriff of the town. Alright, because tarring and feathering someone is definitely better than death, I guess. Either way, there are these four brother
desperados,
robbers, guys. I don't remember what...
The Dalton brothers.
The Daltons. Mm-hmm. And so they're like, we're going to take over the town. And we do actually get a couple of amusing shots that are based on their different sizes because they are just like a tiered... They all look identical except they're all slightly different sizes. So there's a couple of neat shots of them like... walking upstairs and then suddenly they're all the same height or stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's like the best comedy that they get, is just like weird visual gags based on their size.
Mm-hmm.
Lucky Luke beats them, and then he tars and feathers them, and they're driven from the town. Everyone celebrates with a hoedown, and the movie ends. The movie ends at an hour. Man, who would have thought there'd be
Sean.
30 more minutes of credits?
Sean? The movie does not end.
No, I might have left out.
God, I wish the movie ended.
I may have left out all the racism. Mm. And oh God, it is everywhere. The remaining 30 minutes of this movie is the Dalton brothers convincing a Native American tribe to go and attack Daisy Town because white people taking over. And this whole segment is horribly racist. Everything about it is offensive. And it's terrible. And that's not even to say that this is the only racist parts of the movie. No, I left out racist parts in earlier parts because we have the one Mexican guy who, in horrible stereotype fashion, is super lazy, and he just sits outside the saloon the whole movie.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's all he does. That is his joke.
The movie bookends
with him sitting out
in front of the saloon.
And then him standing up and leaving at the end.
When the town is abandoned.
Yeah, to run out the rest of the story real fast. Native Americans attack. The Rangers, the U.S. Army.
The U.S. military.
The U.S. military comes in and saves the day in spectacular timing fashion, as they always do, jabbing fun at Westerns. Okay, cool. And then they find out there's a gold rush out in California, so everyone leaves and the town is abandoned.
It's deserted. Well, okay, no. The Native Americans make a peace treaty with the town.
Oh, come to
and get their
treaty.
Demands like get their demands listened to. They don't even ask for much. Mm-hmm. It's like all very stereotypical Native American things. Like they ask for tobacco and
good roles in movies.
Good roles in movies, and they ask for.
They can sell the. Sell they're the only ones that can sell souvenir
Native
pottery.
Native American souvenir pottery.
And it's like, wow, this is all horrible.
I hate it. And then immediately afterward, the town is abandoned because everybody runs out to California, so it doesn't matter anyway.
Mm-hmm. And then the one Mexican guy looks up for the first time in the movie, looks around, sees everyone's gone, and he gets up and walks out.
And then Lucky Luke takes his horse and moves on to a different town.
Mm-hmm. The other very racist character is there's a single Chinese man in this movie.
Oh, and of course, he's just like
The most stereotyped ever, and it's terrible.
I mean,
okay,
there isn't such a good thing as a good character design in this movie, but like, this is even worse. I don't know if it's clear to anyone yet. I hated this movie. I just thought it was trash. Like,
the worst part is that this movie had effort put into it, which makes it worse.
Yeah. Because
if this was just like shoddily put together like some of the other Westerns we've seen that are just like reused shots over and over and over and over again, it'd still be bad, but it'd be like, oh, this whole thing is bad and like the production is bad too. But no, the production is good, which almost which accents the other parts of it.
I wouldn't call the production good. I think they tried a bit, but like it still feels half-assed and I do not use those words lightly when it comes to this show. I do not like saying a product is half-assed when it comes to animation, because animation is so hard to begin with. But there is so much reused animation here. The plot drags on for no good reason.
Nothing happens.
There is so much that we've seen, because this is the same company that made the Asterix the Gull movies, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And they did.
I'm fairly certain. I didn't double check that. I would assume so.
Those looked I wouldn't say much better, but they had a better flow to them and a better animation overall.
I beg to differ. I think it's on par with those movies, animation-wise, because those weren't very well animated either.
No. It has, like, three amusing jokes, and you pretty much already told them.
Because they're all visual gags.
They're all visual gags, but, like, the rest of the movie is so bad, it just brings the whole thing down to just being utter garbage. I despised this movie. I did not like watching it. I wanted to turn it off. I did not like it whatsoever. And a lot of it is because it's a product of its time, but, like, screw that. I just did not like this movie.
Man, we've watched, like, three Westerns mm-hmm. now, and, like, none of them have made me interested in going to see
any
actual,
other Westerns.
Like, Westerns, because they're all comedies. Well, two of them are comedies made to
parody Westerns.
Parody Westerns.
Yeah. None of the characters are appealing at all. Like, Lucky Luke's only personality traits is that he's better than you.
Doesn't talk much.
He doesn't talk much, and
he smokes constant.
Smokes like a train, you know?
If he doesn't have a cigarette already in his mouth, he's licking one and getting it ready.
And he's rolling one up. Yeah, it's just like, it's just so unappealing. There's nothing likable here. I just don't like any of this. And I could see how there are certain people, especially in the time that this was made, that, you know, like, this would be a cool, fun character. But there's just nothing fun or cool about this kind of character anymore.
No.
It's boring and just, I don't like it. And that's pretty much all I gotta say. I don't want to talk about this movie anymore. I want to forget it existed.
Okay. Well, fair. I personally don't think this movie is the absolute worst thing we've watched here on this show so far, but it's definitely really, really close to the bottom. If not, like, don't remember all the movies we watched, but I just remember the Rankin Bass time travel one was really bad.
Yeah.
Willie McBean and his magic machine.
Yeah.
And I personally think that one was still worse than this one, but not by a whole lot.
I'm ready to move on to hopefully something better.
Cool.
What's our next movie?
Well, we are done with 1971, which means we're moving on to 1972, and that gives us Fritz the Cat.
Oh, man. You've been waiting for it, and now it's here. We've all been waiting for it. Now it's here. I've never watched this movie.
Same. It's time for...
And it is a huge, huge influence on the industry to come.
It's time for American animation to get rated R.
Yeah. So this is a preemptive warning for next week's episode. Next week's episode is rated R. We're watching a rated R movie. It's Fritz the Cat. See y'all there.